Hi, my name is Kyle Houchens. I'm a tech and a trainer for McNeil, and I'm here to show you 3D ribbon offset in Rhino version 7, which is the new and upcoming version. This tool was designed to fill a massive void that is plagues tool makers and anybody who does any molding or anything like that in developing what's called the ribbon surface, which is basically a surface that comes off perpendicular from the edge of your part and helps you to be able to create a mold. The limitation of this currently, let me show you what it used to do and the problem that we fixed. So this is a 3D curve, right? It's got this piece. Let's assume that we're trying to make a mold off of it. We'd have the other half in here. I'm only going to make one half now so you can see what's going on. But this is a 3D curve. It's got a lot of ups and downs in the Z. And let's duplicate this edge. And then let's hide this piece. And I'll show you. I got two curves here. I'll show you what offset does. If we just go up here and use the regular offset, you can see that it creates this self-intersecting curve. It actually doesn't do a terrible job, but you can see that it falls off and doesn't do a great job in here. Got this self-intersection. You'd have to go in and try and clean that up, and it's really, really complex. Doesn't offer any options to rebuild or anything like that. 3D ribbon offset, what it does is allows you, let's just do this off the edge of the surface. It allows you to take the surface edge, offset it, and create a surface all within one tool. So let's run it. The tool is called ribbon offset. We're going to pick the edge. We're going to pick the side to offset, which is out here. And you can see right off the bat, it brings up this dialog box with a preview. The offset distance is up here. In this case, let's do 1.5. And then I can rebuild the curve. I can decide how many points are going to be in this rebuilt curve. Let's do 60. And what that'll allow us to do is actually drop a little detail from our original surface to our parting surface here. The surface creation method, let's do a sweep 2. If we do a sweep 2 and preview it, you can see that it runs. And then it also offers us the ability to actually add slashes and fix our isoparametric wanderings here. So let's go ahead and do that. Pick one there. Pick one here. Let's do one in and out of each one of these big transitions. You can see that we can go in and straighten out the isoparams so that the ribbon surface works a little better. We can determine exactly how we want that to pull. Right-click to accept, say OK, and we've got the ribbon surface generated. To finish the mold, we would actually just take this curve, copy and paste, scale to 0. This is going to give you the center line. It's going to give you the exact half distance between the high point and the low point, which is going to help you determine your mold face. I like to then take and do a regular offset of this curve, not the 3D offset, but a regular offset. We'll do it something like, 3. And then I'm going to offset this again. And this is just a little workflow thing I like to do. Let's say we offset it 5. And then I'm going to make a planar surface. Let's rebuild these. Let's make them a little less dense. Let's rebuild them to 50. Because we want to drop detail as we're going away from the edge of this thing. Let's make a planar surface. And then I'm going to just pull a little trick here. I'm going to untrim this, which gives me my mold face. I'm going to hide my curves. And then I'm going to complete this mold simply by running a blend surface. I'm going to just do it at tangent. We don't need to get crazy. Go to the top view. Let's straighten this out just a little bit. Add a few shapes. Same as adding the slashes in the sweep. I'm going to just back these off just a little bit. Join it up. Add a little thickness to this. Get rid of the top, shift control click, and then join this all back together. And we've got a closed poly surface. All ready to roll. Shade that. You can see that we have a really nice layout for a mold. Let me increase my mesh just a little bit. Tools, options, mesh. I'm going to just clean that up a little bit. See that we have a beautiful mold ready to machine. All courtesy of Ribbon Offset. Give it a shot. This is Kyle Houchens. This is Ribbon Offset in Rhino version 7.